Welcome back, children. Hope all of you are fine and good. Children, it has been a long time since we have met. Really, we all miss you. But hope all of you are safe in your houses and hope your family members are also safe. Let us continue with our chapter, Sustainable Management of Resources. In our previous modules, we had learned about the 5 R's. We also learned about the need for the sustainable management of resources. So in this module, or in today's module, we are going to learn about forests. Why are forests called biodiversity hotspots? Who are the stakeholders for the development or for the conservation of forests? And how are people's management or people around the forest helping in the conservation of forests? With all these things, let us go ahead and let us watch the modules. Thank you. How can we conserve the forest? Forest can be conserved by afforestation. Afforestation means what? Planting more and more trees. Reducing deforestation means prevent the cutting of trees. Even if few trees are cut or if they are damaged, you should always ensure that some more trees should be planted in their place so that the balance is maintained. Third one is to prevent the overgrazing by cattle. You know, cattle or any other grass-eating animals, if they graze through that area for more time, naturally the diversity or biodiversity in that area will be affected. By setting up wildlife sanctuaries, national parks, biosphere reserves, etc., undertaking social forestry programs like Van Mahotsav, Chipko Andolan, etc., for planting and protecting trees on a large scale. You can look at the pictures there, how people are going on planting the trees and how they are growing new trees, how the people are hugging the trees and standing. All these are a part of Chipko Andolan or Chipko movement for planting and protecting the trees on a large scale. Let us go to the next topic, wildlife. Now, what is the importance of wildlife? What do you think? Yes, wildlife is also an important part of the ecosystem. They preserve biodiversity. They are an important component of the food chain. About food chain, you have learned in the chapter, Our Environment. Without animals, can you imagine a food chain? Definitely not. So wildlife also helps to maintain food chain and food web. We get many useful products from the wildlife like food, medicines, leather, bones, honey, lac, etc. Now, why do we conserve? How do we conserve the wildlife? By preserving the natural habitat of the animal. See, children, whichever be the natural habitat, take a tiger or a lion. Now, what is its natural habitat? Definitely, it is the forest. You can't make a tiger or a lion happy by bringing him and closing it in a zoo just because you are entertained by the tiger or a lion. What is the natural habitat of a tiger or a lion? Definitely, the forest. Now, if the hunters are going and killing them unnecessarily, what will happen? Definitely, their number will become less. That is why we have got many endangered species of animals who are almost in danger of becoming extinct. So we should see to it that we are protecting the endangered species of animals also. And we have to set up wildlife sanctuaries. We have to set up national parks, biospheres, etc., biosphere reserves, etc., that will help in conservation of wildlife. Because wildlife also is a very important component of our ecosystem. And preserving the natural habitat of the animals is also one of our main duties. Okay, so let us go to the next topic. Our next topic is about local people. Yes. When I was discussing to you about the stakeholders, children, I asked you a question. Which stakeholder is going to be affected when something happens to a forest? And I gave you the answer that the first stakeholder, that means the local people who are there in or around the forest, they will be affected the most. So you find that the local people take a lot of efforts. They have been working traditionally since many, many years for conserving the forest. With regard to that, one question will be asked. How can you show that the effects are taken by the local people have helped in the conservation of forest? With that reference, you can give the example of Amrita Devi, a Bishnoi woman. Oh, it's a community actually. Bishnois are a type of communities in Rajasthan. So Amrita Devi Bishnoi, who with more than 363 other people died for the protection of Khejri trees near Jodhpur in Rajasthan, because some people were going to come and cut the Khejri trees, and she with along with some 363 people went and sacrificed their lives for the protection of the Khejri trees. So in as a tribute to this lady, our government also has constituted a special award called the Amrita Devi Bishnoi National Award for Wildlife Conservation. So this is an initiative taken by the Indian government. So you can refer that as a as an important example for this answer. Okay. So here the question that can be asked is, how can you show the effect or the effort put by the local people for the conservation of forests? That is your answer. Next, prejudice against the traditional use of forest area has no basis. What do you mean by that? Now, there are some prejudices. Let us give you an example. Suppose government is coming forward and the government says that such big areas of land have to be converted into a biosphere reserve, or a national park can be made, or a dam can be made there, or some other wildlife sanctuary can be made. Why? We are saying that such vast areas of lands are there, and these lands are just being used by the shepherds. They are bringing their sheep here for grazing. And what is the government doing? I'm giving you an example. What is the government doing? The government says that you should ban the shepherds from bringing the sheep here. No grazing of animals should be allowed here. This particular incident happened in the Himalayan National Park. The meadows, you know, alpine meadows, you know, green areas, pasture lands were there. They were grazed by the sheep in the summer. But this practice was stopped when the national park was made. As a result, the grass grew very tall and falls over, preventing fresh growth. So what do you think? Have we disturbed the economic stability? Yes, the harmony of the environment has been damaged. Who is responsible? We are responsible again. Our government means we. We are responsible. We are so greedy, or we are so much commercial enough to prepare a national park that we are not thinking that we are disturbing the ecological balance of the environment. The grasses were being eaten by the deer or by the sheep. By the sheep. Let us take the example of the sheep. The sheep were coming and eating the grasses. So grasses were growing in a uniform manner. But then when the sheep were not allowed to come for grazing, what happened? Grasses naturally grew abnormally and the grasses were coming down. And as a result, fresh growth of grass was not possible. So what have we done? We have prevented the ecological, or we have damaged the ecological balance. Okay, now we go over to another very good example where the people's initiative helped in preserving the environment. That is called Chipko Andolan. That is also a very important question for your examination. What is this Chipko Andolan? Chipko Andolan means, the word Chipko means hug. Hug the trees, you know, just hugging the trees to preserve the trees. That is what some ladies in Uttarakhand, in Garhwal, Himalayas of Uttarakhand did. What happened actually? When a group of women were only present in that village, the name of the village is Reni, some contractors, they came forward to cut the traditional trees or old trees. And this cutting of trees and forests was not liked by these ladies or by the women who were there in that village at that time. So this movement started in the 1970s in the Garhwal Himalayas of Uttarakhand. What actually happened was, when the contractor came to cut the trees, as you can see on the picture, that the ladies, they just hugged the trees and stood there. As a result, the contractor had to go back. So this initiative was appreciated by many people after that, and the same methods or same initiative was shown by some other people in our country to prevent the cutting of trees. So this example is also very important. Write a short note on Chipko Andolan. Now, next topic or next question with reference to our forest is, how can you explain the people's participation in the management of forests? Now, let me explain about this in little more detail. Now, you know, children, that our country was under British rule for many, many years. Now, when the Britishers were about to leave, or when they left, all these forests and all these land areas automatically went to the hands of the government. Now, when these forests went to the government, the local people's interference or local people's influence was very, very less, because the government did not allow the local people to participate in the management of forest. Now, who will be most effective in the management of forest? I'll give you one example. Suppose your home management is it. You are staying in your houses. Who will be managing your house more? Will you be able to manage the school, your house affairs more? Or will I be able to, as a teacher, will I be able to manage your home affairs more? Or will our school be able to manage your home affairs more? Or will your neighbor be able to manage your home affairs more? Definitely, the answer is only you. You only will be able to manage your home affairs, because if anything good or bad happens in your house, who is going to be affected the most? You are only going to be affected. So you will take more care. You will be more sincere. You will be doing your work most effectively. That is what has happened in the case of the forests also. So when the forests were taken over by the government, the people's control became very, very less. As a result, they were not allowed to interfere in the management of the forest. So as a result, the forest's income or revenue, produce, etc. became very, very less. So this problem was understood by a very important or a very famous officer, a forest officer whose name was A.K. Banerjee, in the Arabari forest range of Midnapur district in West Bengal. Mr. Banerjee said that if you have to protect the forest, you have to take the help of the local people, because they can effectively manage the forest. So because of his directive, about 1,272 hectares of badly degraded sal forest were protected and looked after by the people, and the revenue started increasing. So because of the help of the local people, the people were given fuel from the forest or wood from the forest, fodder they could take, they were given a nominal amount of money also, and they were given jobs in silviculture and harvesting. 25% of the final harvest was given to the people. Naturally, when the people saw that they were being paid for their works, the result was that actively they were willing to participate for the improvement of the forest, and the sal forest started yielding more and more revenue. Previously, the value was very, very less, but then its value increased to 12.5 crores. So this example tells you about the people's participation in the management of forests. This is also a very important topic. So with that, we come to the end of some very important topics in this chapter. So let us continue ahead with some more topics. Thank you.